Oh, yeah, and happy March 15th. Apparently, a polar shift is going to happen today, and Planet X and Planet Nibiru and a comet and earthquakes and volcanoes and all kinds of calamities. Oh, I can't wait till this day is over with so people shut up talking about it. But you know what's going to happen. After this date, people are going to talk about the next date of doom. But they're never going to say, hey, you know what? I was wrong. I'm sorry for scaring the hell out of you with that video. No, they're just going to move on to the next date of doom. Ugh, come on, people. Okay, I'm going to do some video responses. Shapiro, Truthcracker, and Montagraph. Montagraph asked if the situation in Japan was so grave, do you think it would make sense for the Japanese government to evacuate the entire people, the entire population from Japan? Well, first I'll start with Shapiro. I think I said that correctly. He asked, could I carry my bug out bag for 4 days? First, my emergency bag back here. It's not that heavy relative to what I can actually carry. I actually cut down on a lot of weight, so I don't think it'll be that much of a problem. I have carried it for about 4 miles or so and didn't really have much of a problem. I don't think it'll be that much of a challenge to do it for 4 days. I mean, it'll be annoying, but it's worth it. The extra weight of the bag and the tent is worth it because, you know, I've slept outside before and I really, really want that tent. It makes a big difference. Okay, Truthcracker wanted to know, how did I hold a camera when I was walking, when I do my outdoor videos? I hold it up like this, you know, just like this. And I point it at myself and I just start talking. I don't use a weird stabilizer or crane or any type of device or anything. I just point the camera at myself and I just start talking. And I think he was drunk in that video. anyway, I assure you I'm not missing out on much. I definitely have my fun. I'll just leave it at that. Anyway, Montagraph was talking about the situation in Japan, and he asked the question, if the situation is so dire, and the Japanese government is aware of the situation, that six reactors could actually explode into a full meltdown and actually put a significant amount of radiation into the atmosphere, should they consider relocating the population, except for people who are needed for essential services, essential operations such as operation of other nuclear power plants and other parts of the infrastructure? I don't know if that will be really practical or even really necessary. I'm not sure they would ever have to evacuate the entire country. Such an operation would take a significant amount of naval forces because you would need the U.S. U.S. Navy is about one of the few navies I can think of that has the capability of transporting a significant amount of people in a short period of time. You would probably need a U.S. Navy. You would need a British Navy. Where would all these people go? I mean, they're not going to China. Which countries would accept them? Maybe some places in Europe. The United States would probably be the best candidates. The U.S. Has a large enough landmass to easily, and enough resources to really take in millions of people anyway. So that would be something that the U.S. might consider doing. There's a political consequence to doing such a thing. I mean, for one thing, you probably scare the hell out of a lot of people by doing that. Another thing is, once a country accepts millions of people from another country, they run the risk that the people may not be able to return. And if the people cannot return, then what do you do with the people who are now in your country? Now, do they have a pathway to citizenship? If that becomes a reality, then you transform the face of your entire country. Are people living in that country willing to take that risk? Are people willing to make sacrifices for other individuals from other countries? That's a question. Which countries will be interested in that? I don't think that's going to be necessary. I don't think they would even have to consider evacuating the entire country. If it does happen, the U.S., maybe France, maybe some other countries would be interested in taking them in. But where exactly would they go? You know, that's a question I would have. Maybe Japan. I mean, Russia. So what do you guys think about the idea of evacuating all of Japan? I think it's a... I'm not saying Montagraph is saying it's going to happen or that it should. I'm just saying the scenario would be pretty extreme. I don't think it's going to get that bad. Let's hope it doesn't get that bad. All right, guys. Thanks for watching, and don't forget the future belongs. Oh, wait, one more thing. Dejan, I hope I didn't even say that name correctly. Anyway, man, thanks for the offer. You offered me a light for my Glock, and I'd just like to say thanks for the offer, but I wouldn't feel right accepting that. You kidding me, man? You know how much money they want for those damn lights? Like $100 and $150 for a damn light on a gun. I'm like, are you kidding me? What's wrong with these people charging that kind of price? Anyway, but thank you for the offer. Guys, don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye. $150.